Every city battles the consequences of the drug crisis. Some struggling with addiction are finding hope through faith. And Joe Sexton at 7 Days, we're talking about a Baptist church called Enough Ministries. What is this? How'd it come about?
The church for those struggling with addiction in Barre is the brainchild of a man named Dan Melind. Dan had grown up in Barre, in a religious household in Barre, had gone off and had a 27-year career in the U.S. military, and including 2 combat tours in Afghanistan. Came back to Barre, was ordained a minister, and along with his wife started a soup kitchen. It became immediately popular as a place to come get a hot meal. But over time, Dan began holding services, religious services, in the same soup kitchen. It became so successful as a little church that they ultimately were invited to come and effectively take over a big, beautiful Baptist church on Washington Street in Barre City. And they've been there since 2019. Dan's idea then was, okay, I have a proof of concept that if you build a church that chiefly serves those struggling with addiction and all the attendant issues, that it can actually succeed and thrive. And so he hired a man named Chuck Clark to come. He has the title of church planter, and he's trying to replicate this church for those struggling with addiction issues. And they're in the early stages of that. The initial services, which are held in the basement kitchen of the Baptist Church on Washington Street, began in August. The hope is to find a new location in the north end of Barre, have a formalized and fully realized church for those battling addiction.
You attended a service, so what'd you see? What was it like?
Well, you know, it's an extremely humble thing. By design, I think that its chief characteristic is that those who come are not judged. There are 2 things that are the ambitions for this church. One is to meet people's physical needs. And so they're very involved in providing people with, you know, food, helping them gain shelter, and then to provide for their spiritual needs. So they don't promise sobriety, it's not a 12-step program, but I think people who are looking for hope and acceptance and also some real material assistance find it at the church.
And is attendance still pretty strong?
The most recent one had as many as 35, but I don't think that's how they would measure their success. It's not the number of people who turn out. It's the, you know, the sort of quality of the interaction. It's the appreciation that, that there are people who are gonna stand by those who are the least fortunate.
It's a fascinating and heart-tugging read, Joe, and it's out in 7 Days now. Joe Sexton, thank you. Be well.
I'm very grateful. Take care.